Morning, Steve Fried in Chicago with the morning grain comments. Well, it continues to be wet across portions of the Midwest. Our weather guy put out a special report this morning talking about this wet pattern will probably continue for another week or two, but then the pattern's going to shift and the rains are going to move further north and west than where they are now. That suggests that the southeast part of the U.S. and parts of the Delta will dry out and see above normal temps. Center of the Midwest will be seeing normal rainfall, normal temps, so there might be some breaks to allow for some planting. But this suggests that for areas like Wisconsin, Minnesota, and the Dakotas, they'll see above normal precip continue for the rest of the month of May. So that could offer some concern about getting crops planted on a timely basis in Wisconsin, Minnesota, and the Dakotas. But there could be a break in the central Midwest. Yesterday we saw a lot of data coming out of the various hard red winter wheat states. For Kansas, there was a trip across northern Kansas that came out with a yield at almost 47 bushels per acre for the wheat. The five-year average is 39. Last year was 38. You've got some people that look for Kansas wheat yield this year to be 46 versus 38 last year. Colorado, the yield was 46.5. That's up 10 bushels from last year. Most people were using a Colorado yield of 40. Nebraska, the trip yield was 44. That's down 2 bushels from their yield last year. Most people are using a Nebraska wheat yield of 50 versus 49 last year. Oklahoma crop number came out 120 million bushels versus 70 last year. People are using a 35 bushel yield for Oklahoma versus 28. So a lot of questions of where this wheat's going to go with production numbers as big as they are versus a year ago. We did see the Treasury Secretary and the Trade Representative both said they have productive meetings with the Chinese Vice Premier, and they will continue their talks in Washington next week. There is a report out of Washington that the President of the United States has backed off on one of his conditions about cybersecurity, and that could lead to a better chance of getting some kind of conclusion to the trade discussion as early as next week. There is some data out of the University of Illinois that said that from 1981 to 2016, they found that during some years, excessive rainfall reduced U.S. corn yield by as much as 34% relative to the expected yield. Now, in drought conditions and excessive heat, yield loss is 37% during the same year. So kind of adds a little bit to some of the concern about planting, especially after, let's say, May 20th, that we start losing yields. And get that kind of perspective on what's going on. July beans yesterday made new lows. There really isn't a lot of bounce in July beans unless there's a trade deal. You've got too much crops coming out of South America and lower demand in China because of the African swine fever. The July corn has bounced up and is now testing the 20-day moving average, trying to figure out if that has anything to do with weather. And we'll see above the 20-day moving average if the funds want to start liquidating out of their record short position in the corn. July wheat also made new lows yesterday. Maybe there'll be some consolidation now from an oversold situation. But these hard red winter wheat reports talk about more acres in spring wheat, Canada, and also the U.S., and bigger crops in Europe and Russia than a year ago probably will limit the upside in wheat unless there is a deal that includes wheat to China. So all in all, still choppy trade. Maybe corn's finding some support because of the weather. We'll be watching any news about the trade deal between U.S. and China, and we'll be watching the money flow with the funds record short grains and oil seeds. As always, these are my thoughts and not those of ADM or ADM Investor Services. Have a safe and profitable trading day.